Welcome to our channel, Forensics for You, and today we are going to discuss about blood and its composition. Now let us discuss about the components of blood. So to find out about the components of blood, what we do is we take a blood in a test tube and then centrifuge it for a fixed period of time. Then we'll see that there are three partitions in a test tube. These three partitions are the components of blood. The first component is plasma. Due to very low density among all the three components, this occupies the first layer and also known as the supernatant. The middle layer is also known as the Buffy coat that contains the WBCs and the platelets. And the last and the bottommost layer is of RBCs. They are the most dense component of the blood. So for better understanding of the components of blood, we'll discuss it with the help of this flowchart. So blood is basically divided into two parts, the plasma and the cells. The cells are also known as the formed elements. These cells are divided into erythrocytes, leukocytes and the thrombocytes. The leukocytes are further divided into granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes are the cell that contains granular cytoplasm, while agranulocytes are the cells whose cytoplasm is deprived of the granules. The granulocytes are further divided into neutrophils, eosinophils and the basophils. And agranulocytes are further divided into monocytes and lymphocytes. Plasma. Plasma comprises 55% of total blood volume. It contains 90 to 92% of water, while other 1 to 10% consist of other material, which includes hormones like steroids and thyroid, gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide, proteins like globulins, albumin and fibrinogen, electrolytes like some cations and anions, waste material like urea, uric acid, creatinine and ammonium, nutrients like amino acids, carbohydrates, vitamins and fatty acids. Hemoglobin. It is the red color oxygen carrying pigment that imparts red color to the blood. It is made up of polypeptide chain and the heme protein. So the next is erythrocytes, also known as RBCs and red blood cells. It comprises of about 45% of total blood volume. These are circular, biconcave and non-nucleated cells. But juvenile RBCs consist of nucleus. The RBCs contain 62.5% of water, 35% of hemoglobin and 2.5% of sugar, lipids, protein, enzymes of glycolytic system. The diameter of RBCs is about 7.3 micrometer, and if we talk about its thickness, then at center it is 1.2 to 1.5 micrometer and 2 to 2.4 micrometer at its periphery. RBC count at the time of birth is about 6 to 7 million per microliter, while in adult male it is 5 to 6 million per microliter, and in adult female it is 4.5 to 5.5 million per microliter. Leukocytes, also known as WBCs and white blood cells. It comprises approximately 1% of total blood volume. It is further divided into two types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. As the name says, the cytoplasm of these cells contain granules. These are further divided into three types: neutrophils, which is 50 to 70% of WBCs, eosinophils 1 to 4%, and basophils are less than 1%. Agranulocytes are the cells whose cytoplasm do not contain granules. These are further divided into two types: lymphocytes and monocytes. Lymphocytes are about 20 to 40% and monocytes are about 2 to 8%. Neutrophils. These are polymorphonuclear leukocytes. Its size varies from 10 to 14 micrometer in diameter. Its nucleus is purple and multilobe, and lobes varies from 1 to 6 in numbers. Number of lobes is directly proportional to the maturity of the cell. That means more the number of lobes, the more mature is cell. Young cells have horseshoe-shaped nucleus. Granules are fine, sand-like, also known as pinpoint granules. These are neutrophilic in nature. They liberate histamine and peroxidase enzyme. The next is eosinophils. Their size varies from 10 to 14 micrometer in diameter. Its nucleus is bilobed and purple in color. Both the lobes are connected with chromatin thread, producing spectacle appearance. Its granules are coarse and contain very high peroxidase content and lysozymes. Basophils. Its size varies from 10 to 14 micrometer in diameter. Its cytoplasm is slightly basophilic and appears blue. Its granules are coarse and are plenty in number, which results in obscure boundary of nucleus. It contains histamine, heparin, and eosinophil chemotactic factor of anaphylaxis. Lymphocytes. They may be large or may be very small. Large lymphocytes varies in size from 10 to 14 micrometer in diameter, while the small lymphocytes varies from 7 to 14 micrometer in diameter. Lymphocytes contain single big purple color nucleus, which can be round, oval, or in indented shape. Cytoplasm appears pale blue in color. The next is monocytes. These are the largest WBCs, and its size varies from 10 to 18 micrometer in diameter. The lifespan of monocytes is approximately 3 months. It contains single nucleus having pale staining and is round or indented in shape. Cytoplasm is usually pale blue and clear. Thrombocytes, also known as platelets. These are the smallest blood cells whose size varies from 2 to 5 micrometer in diameter. The lifespan of platelets is about 8 to 12 days. If you like our video today, please like, share and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. If you need help with any notes or any topic or written material or study material, then you can write to us on given email ID and do follow us on our social platform on Facebook, on Instagram. You can also join our Telegram channel for any study related content. Thank you for watching this.